Established in 1989 to rescue and rehabilitate children that were orphaned and rendered homeless by the liberation wars in the 1970s and 80s, Masulita Children's Village is now a reception center for children rescued from the city streets. According to the Ministry of Gender, the facility is currently housing over 900 children, majority of whom are Karamajong children picked off the city streets. Today, the First Lady of Uganda, Janet Museveni, who was represented by the first daughter, Natasha Karugiri Museveni, had a guided tour at the facility where she commissioned two dormitories and other buildings that were refurbished by Tororo Cement.
Two water tanks over here.
In her speech, she lauded the Uganda women's effort to save orphans, Uweso, for the work done in supporting and transforming the vulnerable women and children in Uganda.
Had only one person trying to look after them as best he could in a dire situation. I resolved to do my part in caring for orphans' children in Uganda as my service to the Lord. I called a women's meeting at the police officer's mess in Naduru, and so many women turned up to my surprise. It is at that meeting that the women of Uganda took it upon themselves to look after the children of Uganda who were in need, and Uweso was born.
Olive Lumonya, the chairperson of Uweso National Executive Committee, highlights some of the achievements of Uweso in the past three decades of its existence and how it has transformed thousands of lives through rehabilitation.
Because Masulita initially raised children after the war, orphans. After the war, the children had been abandoned. They were brought into the village, looked after. Many of them are big boys. We have some who are doctors, we have some who are two engineers, we have a program head, actually, so they grew up here from the war. Now, that has been overtaken by events. We don't have the wars anymore. So the next problem we have, because programs, you respond according to the situation. Now, we have the street children in the country.
Tororo Cement Chief Executive Officer Manish Vasani pledged to continue extending charity to vulnerable communities to ensure all Ugandans can enjoy a health and comfortable life. He further urged all Ugandans to join the government and other private companies in extending services to the vulnerable communities.
In Mukono, we have 500 children that we look after. Disabled, orphaned, malnourished, and kinds of different kinds of diseases, I would say. But this is all because of the blessings of God that He is telling us to follow the path. It is also there in the Bible and also in the 50th wedding anniversary. I remember Moses said that looking after orphans, disabled children, widows is something that is close to God. So we are just following that. All of us, I think, should follow that.
The reason as to why we come here is to see how we can support the children that have been taken off the streets, the orphans that have no homes, to nurture them and have a better Uganda tomorrow, because these are the leaders for tomorrow. So I call upon all the youthful businessmen like I am, and all the Ugandans with the patriotic heart, and all those that are interested to save and help these children. They need food, they need shelter. Last month, January, they took about 1,000 and more children off the road.
The Children's Village is run by the Uganda Women's Effort to Save Orphans, Uweso, an organization that is headed by the First Lady of Uganda, Janet Museveni. It also rehabilitates children rescued from the streets of Kampala. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.